No, Deb Tuck, to human rights activist, to our new horror movie, Tone Deaf,
yes.
Straight from Madrid, AnnaLynne McCord.
AnnaLynne,
thanks. Good morning.
Hi, guys.
So you literally just got off a flight from Madrid.
Literally just got off, well, just like this.
Yeah, fabulous. Yeah.
Took out the cornrows.
Yeah, exactly.
Talk about a little bit about Tone Deaf. Unique premise, huh?
It's a very politically correct way to put it. It's a very politically incorrect film. I work a lot with Richard Bates, the director, and I've done almost all of his films, and he likes to drive the point home about what's going on in our world. And there's so many things going on in our world. We're seeing that today, obviously, just more stuff that just breaks your heart. So it's our job as artists to challenge society, but also to give you some entertainment and an escapism, mm-hmm. and somewhere where you can laugh, because it's just too heavy sometimes. So he likes to do both. He likes to bring up points like, you know, how sad millennials are and how the older generation doesn't understand their lingo, LOL, IDKIRLL.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But it's this compare and contrast between millennials and baby boomers, but yeah. with like a horror film undertone.
With a horror film undertone, and if you have a morbid sense of humor like me, you're laughing. If you don't see the film, because it's got a sense of humor in there that you're just mm-hmm. like, whoa. But it is. I think horror is, especially in the indie world, it's a place where you can actually have drama and you can talk about these things, but you can do it in this heightened way where everything's crazy. And so it's a crazy horror comedy thing.
What about your character?
So my character, I have a really, really important set of three lines. because I'm required to do every film that Ricky does. This one was just a cameo, but I literally am just showcasing the worst of us.
Oh.
Oh my God, you guys, like, things are so difficult in my life.
Well, that transitions beautifully into the clip. Let's take a look.
Oh, perfect.
What? You need to get out of the city for a bit. Decompress.
No, yeah, that's a really good idea. Last year, I took paternity leave to bond with my fur baby. I rented a place through R&R so Chow Bella could run around the yard. It was the most therapeutic experience we've ever had.
Well, I'm not exactly rolling in dough at the moment, ladies, on account of I was just fired.
So that's Amanda Crew from Silicon Valley too, right?
Right, and she actually is dating Dustin Milligan, who was my first boyfriend on 90210. It's like
full circle,
really? Everything comes around.
Wow.
So you've also got a pretty unique charity as well.
I do. It's a passion project. I've been working for the last decade fighting human trafficking, raising awareness for this issue. I took over as president of Together One Heart back in 2016. And Madrid was actually, we have a film that Together One Heart sponsored called Milkshake Girls, which follows a story in Toledo, Ohio that really happened several years ago. Two young girls who were taken and kept in a house six mm-hmm. miles from their parents' home mm-hmm. and sold, like being sold as, you know, sexual slaves.
Why did you feel the need to get involved in that?
Oh, it's a very, very long story.
Okay,
I'll have to come back tonight. But okay. It's a very personal, there's a lot of very personal reasons, things that have happened to me throughout my childhood. And I've talked a lot about this actually at colleges and TED Talks and stuff, that I've been through assault. This is like a thing that's really, really deeply personal.
Near and dear.
And it's an issue that we all have. Slavery is a global issue. We have to do something about it. We can't sell humans. It's terrible. Like, well, it's not okay.
AnnaLynne, thank you for coming in, and thank you for doing great things.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Don't forget, Tone Deaf, it's theaters and on demand Friday.
Good to see you.
Thanks. Thank you, guys.